Hello and welcome to session 111 of the AISafety.com reading group. Tonight we'll be discussing an article called A Survey of Artificial General Intelligence Projects for Ethics, Risks and Policy by Seth Baum. Seth Baum is the founder and executive director of the Global Catastrophic Risk Institute. The article is available at this link and has been on a paywall roughly 50% of the time when I've tried to click on the link, so it's possible that some of you have been unable to access it. The survey are the first survey of all AGI projects, as far as I know, and it's from November 2017, so reasonably recent. The three dimensions promised are ethics, risk, and policy, but Seth Baum actually looks at a number of other factors as well. I have only read the executive summary, the main results, and the conclusion, and not gone far into the methodology, which will not be covered here. Artificial general intelligence is AI that is general, whereas most research and development right now is regarding narrow artificial intelligence. However, there is quite a lot of research and development being done on AGI, much more than you would naively expect, since most people believe it to be far away. This endeavor is often categorized as high risk, high reward, because an actor getting a strong lead in AGI development might have very high rewards, but this is also a very speculative goal. This survey is the first ever survey of these projects. The survey has only used public sources and a somewhat limited number of public sources, which means that there is no guarantee that this is a complete list of all projects. In particular, it is plausible that some projects are not public at all, and these, of course, says Baum, has had a hard time finding. The survey shows seven dimensions for each of the 45 AGI projects identified. The first is the type of institution, whether it's academic or corporate, whether it publishes open source or it's closed source, whether there are military connections to this project, the nationality both of the projects and its supporters, the goals for the AGI, should it be developed, and to what extent it engages with AI safety. And finally, as a proxy for how successful we can expect the project to be, the overall size of the project is also very important and has also been measured. As for the type of institution, it seems from this graph that it is split between 20 of the 45 that are academic and a number of corporations, of which some are publicly held and some are privately held, and a few government and non-profits. Note that there are more than 45 here, as some projects are in more than one category. So, for the academic projects, we should be a bit more, we should not expect an AGI race to be very strong, because academia in general prides on being collaborative, whereas corporations could, in theory, be much more cutthroat. We should expect that an important project in analyzing these is what Seth Baum calls AGI profit research and development synergy, and that is the circumstances where long-term AGI delivers short-term profits. And in this case, corporations, in particular public corporations, will be unlikely to share their developments because they are searching for the stereotype of publicly held corporations are that they only care about the results for the next quarter. Whether they publish the source or not is another parameter that Seth Baum has investigated. And in general, a bit more of them have the source code open 25, and some have restrictions, and 17 have the source code not available. So there is, I guess, more open source than you would expect at first. Seth Baum distinguishes between two kinds of open source: classical open source, where all the development is done in a public fashion, and corporate open source, which only shows the end result and not the process. The military connections: by far, most projects do not specify whether they have military connections at all. Of those that do, 4 projects explicitly reject military connections, and 9 projects do have military connections. Of these, 1 is based in Singapore and the rest in the United States. There are a number also of those who don't have military connections that reject, and some just are transparent enough that it's possible that they do to see that they don't have. It appears also that the interest from the military are in very mundane subjects. They are not trying to build an AGI that tries in a very broad sense to make sense of the world, but more solve very small and specific problems, even if they are looking for artificial general intelligence. And the effort that the military puts into AGI research is very low. Of course, more covered projects are possible. Here, Seth Baum, and I guess it's unreasonable to expect him to uncover secret military projects, but you should be aware that more covered projects are indeed very possible. The geographic location of these projects favor the United States to a huge extent, where 23 projects are primarily based in the United States and 7 partner projects are based in the United States. This come out to 30 out of the 45 projects, which is a rather strong dominance. Of the rest of the projects, a lot of them are in countries that would normally be called strong US allies. There are a few in Russia and China as the only ones that are in some sense plausibly opposed to the development in the United States. The goal of the AGI projects are for roughly 1/3 intellectualists, meaning the pursuit of knowledge. Roughly another 1/3 is for the good of humanity, and a number of them have different goals, and a surprising amount do not actually have any particular goals. But the intellectualist and humanitarian goals strongly dominate this. It is possible, maybe even plausible, that some of the corporate projects are what Seth Baum calls blue washing, as an analogy to green washing, where corporations try to be more green than they are. Then blue washing, with the blue color coming from the helmets that the United Nations peacekeepers have, some corporations might try to be more humanitarian than they actually are. It's quite plausible that much more of the corporate projects are motivated by profits than what they plausibly state. However, none of them state the two goals: military advantage or selfish benefits. Seth Baum writes that Ben Guetzel is an exception to this. It's quite unclear precisely what he's an exception to. Maybe he is doing AGI projects for military advantage or selfish benefits. It's quite unclear precisely what Seth Baum means here. And I don't know. I looked at Ben Goetzel's website and Wikipedia article. It's not clear that he's doing it for any kind of military advantage, at least. Then the sixth dimension that Seth Baum looks at the AGI projects for is the engagement with the AI safety community. Most of the projects don't write anything about AI safety. Of those that do, a bit more than half are active and positively engaged with AI safety, and some are just moderate, and a few, 2 projects, are explicitly dismissive of the need for any particular safety with regards to artificial general intelligence. In particular, these research projects, even if they are active on safety, work much, much less with AI safety than we in the reading group would probably call prudent. In particular, academic projects are the worst with regards to artificial general with safety for their AGI projects. And there is a focus on, in those that care about safety, about training the AGI to be safe. And that is a method that much of the professional AI safety community have, if not rejected, then strongly believes will not be sufficient. Of those who care about AGI safety, there is also a wider focus on short-term AGI safety than in the AI safety community. The sizes of the project vary, here Seth Baum doesn't he puts them into categories: small, medium, large, large, and one that's unspecified. A project that is explicitly trying to publish as little as possible. The reason Seth Baum is unable to give concrete numbers to these classes is that almost all of these projects don't write how many people are full-time employed on these AGI projects, just how many people are contributing, and if they don't write how, to what extent they're contributing, if it's 5% of their time or 100%, then there is just too much uncertainty to say anything in particular. It seems as a general trend that the corporate projects are larger than the academic. This might be because a lot of people are only partially available in some projects rather than other. He is not certain about this trend. It also appears that larger projects are more likely to be open source, and the projects that have military connections are in general quite small. There is also a note about the Chinese projects. They seem to be very small, but embedded in companies like Baidu, which have a huge AI department, meaning that they have the potential to scale up very, very rapidly, even though the projects themselves are very small right now. All these results, Seth Baum has tried to put this into a graph, and I will try to reveal this graph a little to show this. So there are two. The primary dimension is whether the projects are engaged on safety or not engaged on safety. This is further subdivided into whether it's academic, corporate, or other kinds of projects. And we have on the horizontal axis whether it's humanitarian or intellectualist goals, whether it's both, whether it's profits or unspecified. So the first up here, we have a few projects that are academic, engaged on safety, and have intellectualists or intellectualist and humanitarian goals. They are up here. The text size represents that they're small, that flags the nationality. And then there appears to be some kind of cluster in here, corporate projects with humanitarian or also intellectualist goals that are engaged in AI safety. In particular, we have DeepMind, one of the three largest AGI projects. There are a number of other projects with other goals, a few Canadians and a British project. And finally, we have some projects that are neither academic or corporate: OpenAI, which is, I guess, a non-profit, and the Whole Brain Architecture Institute, which is governmental for Japan. But these are all engaged on AI safety. And there is also Cogprime as a notable one, which doesn't specify its goals to any substantial extent. As for those that are not engaged in AI safety, we have a huge cluster here, which Seth Baum calls the Academic Intellectualists Not Engaged on Safety cluster. And in particular, a subcluster here, which are also in the United States, and military projects. In particular, here we have it's a Swiss project, and I guess it's mostly based in Switzerland, but most of the EU, European Union, contribute to some extent. And this is a large project which doesn't care about AI safety and write anything about AI safety. Further, there are a number of corporate projects with varying goals, and another number of other, in particular Chinese projects that are small, not engaged on safety, and governmental. In China, it can sometimes be a bit difficult to precisely distinguish which is governmental, which is corporate, because many of the corporations in China have a strong governmental, if not oversight, then influence. And finally, there are a number of smaller projects which have other or unspecified goals, mostly not engaged on AI safety. They're small, they're all over the world, and probably not very interesting. Only one that should probably be mentioned here is SICK, which is one of the larger corporate projects. It has a small font here. I believe actually it might be so much larger than this, but this is another project that doesn't really specify its goals and doesn't care about AI safety. So in total, there are four clusters. The cluster of intellectualist projects that are not active on safety. I've used an ivory tower for my for the image for this cluster. Then there's the humanitarian projects that are active on safety. Those are, of course, I guess if a project would, we would want win the AGI race, but we really hope there will be no AGI race. Then there are the US-based military-connected projects that are not active on safety. I've chosen rather disparagingly to use some toy soldiers to represent these projects because I do not believe that they are very serious. And then there are the Chinese projects which are not very impressive right now, but embedded in large organizations and are ones to watch because they could potentially become really, really big, really fast. So the a number of conclusions are actually available from the survey. Of course, the survey itself is not perfect. There are a number of limitations, but some conclusions can be had. The first is that the two most common kinds of projects are humanitarian and intellectualists. And these goals actually are not just, they're not very different from each other. They're somewhat different, but even within these two clusters, there seems to be a consensus on the goals. And that's, of course, very promising. There is also a problem that the projects don't address AGI safety in the academic world, which is why Roman Jampolsky's suggestion of some kind of research survey boards, which are very commonly used in medicine, might be very helpful. I think actually this is what kind of counterintuitive. When I before I read this survey, I would have expected the corporate goals to be less caring about AGI safety and the academic projects to care more about AGI safety, but it turned out to be the other way around. And to avoid a race for AGI, some kind of collaboration seems required, and that seems to be easier due to the fact that the actual projects seem to have the same goals. And they are also in countries that are very friendly, the United States and allies, basically. And there are a number of visible interconnections between the projects, people who work on more than one of these projects. Policy work is something that is sometimes presented as very difficult because you need to basically get the entire world to collaborate on slowing down AGI research, and that seems very problematic to do in the United Nations, but actually doing it in the United Nations might not be required if all the projects are in the United States and their close allies. So that makes policy work quite a bit more feasible. And the review boards that should definitely be a suggestion for how to evaluate this kind of risky research, even if it's very speculative. Then there's the fact that a lot of the projects are open source. Nick Bostrom has written a research paper called On the Strategic Implications of Openness in AI Research. And this argues that this expectation of openness could actually be problematic when we get closer to actually feasible AGI. Then Seth Baum also points out that we should, when analyzing these projects, we should look at the political economy of the projects, in that short-term profits like Google trying to use AGI to bring down the heating costs in their research centers, these kind of things, in their computer, in the supercomputers, these kind of things. If they generate a short-term profit, then Google is much less likely to collaborate with competitors. That is all for tonight. Thank you, and see you next week.